Hey everyone, it's been a while since I've made a video. If you're curious, I've left my excuses in the description. I wanted to make a video on this integral for a long time, but it doesn't lend itself well to animation, so I figured I might as well try a new style that's more similar to Flammable Maths, Dr. Payam and Black Pen Red Pen, but of course with my own twist. In future, I hope to find a balance between Blackboard-style videos and animations. So the problem at hand is the integral of the natural log of x over the natural log of x over the natural log of x over, I think you get the picture. This is called an infinitely nested function or infinitely nested recursion. Often the easiest way to go about this is to play around with our function and see if we can find a closed form expression of it. We're going to start by setting y equal to the natural log of x over the natural log of x over repeating. Notice that the expression in blue is actually exactly equal to the red stuff, since it's infinitely nested. And we've actually set this equal to y, which means that y is equal to the stuff in blue. So y equals the natural log of x over y. We can exponentiate both sides to get e to the y equals x over y. Notice that the natural log cancels out with the e. If we then multiply by y, we get y times e to the y equals x. There's no real way to isolate y, so we'll have to use this tool called the Lambert W function. If you don't know what that is, don't worry because I'm about to explain it in more depth. So, how do we define the Lambert W function? Well, we start with a function f of x equals x times e to the x. We then define the inverse of this function as the Lambert W function. There's no real way to take the inverse of this neatly, so instead we define this arbitrary function w to be the inverse. It's got a couple of useful identities that I'll talk about in future videos, but there's only one key identity that we'll need here. We'll start off with taking f of w of x. And since w is now the argument of our function, it should be easy to see that instead of x times e to the x, we'll have w of x times e to the w of x. However, from up here, we can also see that w is just equal to f inverse. So we can replace this w with f inverse of x. By the definition of inverse functions, we can see that this f inverse and this f cancel out, and we're just left with x. Now, since these two lines are equal, we can see that w of x times e to the w of x equals x. This seems like a fairly arbitrary statement, but I just wanted to make sure that we knew it going forward. So, in order to integrate w of x, we're going to use a substitution to make our life a little bit easier. We're going to substitute u equals w of x. By the definition of w, we can see that u times e to the u would be equal to x. If we differentiate both sides with respect to u, we can use the product rule. Derivative of the first, which is just 1, times the second, plus the second times derivative of the first. And we can just write this as dx du. Now, in one swoop, we're going to factor out this e to the u, and that's going to give us u plus 1 times e to the u. And we can also think about multiplying this dw through. Of course, that's not technically what's happening, but for all intents and purposes. So now we're just going to plug this back into our integral. Recall that w is just equal to u, and our dx is now equal to u plus 1 e to the u times du. Now we could break this into two separate integrals, but it's going to be easier just to distribute this u, and we're going to end up with the integral of u squared plus u times e to the u du. What we've set ourselves up here is a nice little integration by parts problem. Instead of doing everything by hand, we're going to use tabular or the DI method. So we start with taking the derivative of our u squared plus u term, and we're going to be integrating our e to the u. Also, don't forget the alternating pluses and minuses along the side. So The derivative of u squared plus u is just going to be 2u plus 1. This derivative is 2, and then 0. And of course, e to the u is just going to get us e to the u every time. Because of the way tabular integration works, we're going to multiply these alternating signs by their corresponding functions, and then multiplying them across the diagonal. If we do this, we're going to start with plus u squared plus u times e to the u. Then we're going to have minus 2u plus 1 e to the u. And then we're going to have plus 2 e to the u. Then we can factor out the e to the u. Notice that this is going to be a minus because we're distributing the minus sign. We can then group all of the like terms in here. So u squared is by itself, and then plus u minus 2u is just going to be minus u, and then minus 1 plus 2 is just plus 1. We can distribute our e to the u back in here. So this first term is going to be u squared times e to the u, but I'm actually going to write it out fully as u times u times e to the u. You'll see why in just a second. Then we have minus u e to the u, and plus e to the u. Now, we're not done quite yet because we still need to put this back in terms of w and x. Remember that u is just w of x, so from the identity we proved earlier, this u e to the u can just be written as x. And u, of course, is just w of x. Again, we're going to be subtracting u e to the u, which is just x. And we're going to be adding e to the u. We can't really write this in any nice way, so we're just going to leave this as e to the w of x. And there we have it. Our final answer is equal to x times w of x minus x plus e to the w of x. And that's how we integrate the Lambert W function. If you liked the video, give it a like. If you spotted any mistakes or have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. Thanks for watching.